This is Malindi, a beautiful treasure, a famous tourist destination with stunning sandy beaches and gorgeous expensive resorts. Being one of the historical towns found at the Kenyan coastline, Malindi boasts of a rich heritage full of unique cultural sites. Fishing is the most popular economic pillar sustaining many families. On this beautiful sandy beach, we find Baba Jumbo, a fisherman who has lived and worked here for over 40 years. On a lucky day, a good catch could earn him a decent check from one of the beach resorts. But this was not a lucky day. He returns home empty-handed. Beyond the shoreline is this Mijikenda village, home to over 300 families. Here, life is different, far from the glamour and color that creates the beauty of a tourist destination. Jumbo's dad returns home from an empty fishing day. At his homestead, he's greeted by a jovial Jumbo, a 13-year-old full of hope. Jumbo is a flamboyant dancer, the star of the village. He wants to be a footballer when he grows up. He dreams of playing for Manchester United one day.
Mimi naitwa Jumbo. Nataka nicheze kwa timu ya Manchester United. Nataka kuwa superstar wa kila kitu. Niko dansa.
But beyond Jumbo's cheerful life, there is a hidden agony and pain. Jiggers. Jumbo's feet are in a mess, heavily infested with jiggers. Jumbo's days are filled with shame and stigma as young girls in the village laugh at his flea-infested legs.
Jumbo anataka kucheza mpira, lakini hawezi. Marafiki yake wanacheza, yeye hawezi. Hata kusoma, hasomi vizuri. Manake mwalimu anafundisha na yeye anajikuna. Hapati kitu. Hata kula mwanangu alikuwa si sana vile. Na kujikuna usiku usiku. Mayai inaanguka hata kwenye kitanda.
Silali mara nyingine, naamka asubuhi, siwezi kuvaa viatu, najikuna.
And this is the life of many other families at this Mijikenda village, just a stone throw away from Malindi town center. Known as the Tunga Penetrans, the Jiga always find itself into various parts of the body, especially the toes, fingernails, ankles, elbows, palms, and sometimes even parts of the main body. The flea flourishes by feeding on blood and growing inside the body where it lays eggs. In most cases, the infestation leads to fibrosis, gangrene, and amputation of fingers or limbs, and sometimes leads to death.
Jiggers were first introduced into the African continent from the Caribbean. And since then, they seem mostly to be concentrated on an area of low social economic status, and they seem to favor a warm climate. We are at Mijikenda village. It's a seaside village right at the beach, and it's a haven for the jiggers. I mean, there's loose sandy soil right here. And then if you look at the structures, they're basically made of makuti, that's palm leaves. And this is rich organic material that provides food to the larvae and to the adult jiggers.
Ranked as one of the poorest counties in Kenya, Kilifi is among the worst hit counties, with thousands of families heavily affected by the troublesome flea. According to national estimates, over 3 million Kenyans are heavily affected by this small but dreadful flea. But there is hope. Bimbin Africa has found a solution to this agony. Having lived in Malindi for 40 years, Italian businessman Pierre Luigi Caffini spent 2 years working on trials in a bid to find a long-lasting solution that will eradicate the jiggers and alleviate the agony associated with it.
After 40 years living here, and it's a long time, I had the possibility to know also the local people. I know their problem, and I saw that one of the worst problems for them is jiggers and bed bugs. Now we try to resolve this problem of jiggers, but already we are studying also in this problem of bedbugs that make the population don't sleep in the nights. In Kenya, almost 3 million people are affected by jiggers. That is a problem for all the Saharan Africa and also in South America and in Caribbean. Many NGOs, they try to resolve this problem, but after some disinfectant and what is the best solution up to now was to dig inside with needles and remove the animals and the eggs. As after a research of 2 years by our doctors, we find a solution that with a blend of medicine and with a kind of special application, we can kill the jiggers in 5 days.
This trial was conducted in Kilifi County, where several affected families were treated by our team that included doctors.
Naitwa nani?
Jumbo.
Jumbo. Hey, Jumbo. So, na mimi naitwa Bridget.
So this is Jumbo. And so these are his feet. And we can see evidence of really heavy infestation. As you can see, some of the nails are not there. They've fallen off or he's removed them. And signs of secondary infection. The toes look gangrenous. This black skin discoloration. And under the toes too. Yeah, there are also signs of heavy infestation. You can see the holes left behind from his own interventions of trying to remove the jiggers with thorns. Yeah, so the sites are getting infected. So these are some of the dangers associated with the traditional method, which includes using needles, thorns to prick the skin and push out the egg and the parasite itself. So it can lead to secondary infections at the site.
After cleaning the feet with disinfectants, a special blend of cream is first applied to all affected areas.
So right now I'm applying the cream that is meant to take care of the tungiasis and at the same time also take care of any lesions, and put some antibiotic into them.
Then a thick coat of gel is applied to help suffocate the flea.
So at this point you may want to tell the patient about what to expect during the treatment. So as the jiggers are dying off, they will try and escape. So it's bound to get a bit itchy, but they will have to brave through that phase of the treatment.
A specially designed glove is then fitted to cover the medicine and allow the patients to comfortably carry on with their daily routine.
So next is the stage whereby we will dress the feet in the special glove socks. So it's impregnated with jelly already. It's been done already, and also a bit more of the medication. We've tried to make it as ergonomic as possible. It will still, the patient will still be able to do minimal movement about, as you can see. So the design is quite ergonomic, but at the same time effective.
This should stay in place for 2 to 3 days for effective healing.
It's been held in position, but at the same time, the blood supply to the foot is not strangulated. This new cure is a blend of several agents. And apart from killing the jiggers, it has an antibiotic that ensures no further infection of the cavities. And it works in 2 to about 3 days. The problem of jiggers is rid. And also the public is educated on the circle of infectivity when it comes to tungiasis and their thought how to intervene and prevent further spread of jiggers.
Kuna daktari mwingine hawakuntimu kabisa, lakini nyinyi mkantimu. Sasa ndivyo naanza kupata nafuu ya hawa wadudu wa mafunzi. Usiku mkanivisha haya usiku, nikasikia kuwasho na wale funzi kajikuna, lakini nikawaacha nikawaacha, nikamwambia mamangu awafunza kama wanaanza kukufa. Kitambo nilikuwa siwezi tembea kama saa pale, lakini sasa wanasofa. Umeona hivi, kwa sababu nimekuja nyinyi madaktari nyinyi mkanisaidia vizuri, Sasa ndivyo naanza kupona sasa.
Haya matibabu yamesaidia sana jamii, na kweli ikiwa yataendelezwa basi hii huduma itasaidia watu wengi zaidi. Kwa hivyo naomba hili shirika liendelee kuleta madawa ili watu wafaidike sana.
2 days later, the team returns to find a different Jumbo, happy and full of life.
Hey Jumbo, sasa bari ya siku nyingi?
Nzuri.
Umekuwa ukiendeleaje?
Kwa siku hivi nasikia vinawasha.
Eh.
Nikavumilia mimi.
Ah, good boy.
Kumba.
So when we first encountered Jumbo, this side of the foot was badly infected. There was an active infective process going on. And then there were signs of repeated healing with scarring and fibrosis. And it was a mess, but so far, in about 2 days, there's been great process. So for example, right here is a cavity created by a female jigger. It had burrowed in and then laid its eggs and left a small hole or operculum, yeah, through which to breathe and through which to lay eggs. You can see we squeezed out of the already expanded hole without even having to prick with the pins and everything. We just squeezed out the dead jigger and the eggs.
And the eggs
through this hole.
You think it's not anymore now?
Yes, there are none left. To prevent new infestations and also aspects of secondary infection through the cavities left behind, we have to give Jumbo shoes, which he will keep on. And we've educated him on the basics of the life cycle of the jigger, the infective stage, how it clutches onto the feet and then burrows. So he fully understands. Unaelewa umuhimu wa kuvaa viatu sasa, sawa? So, yes, that is it.
Pale zamani nilikuwa siwezi kabisa kutembea. Lakini sasa naweza tembea, naweza kufanya kitu chochote, naweza kuondoka hapa paka baharini. Tena nikaregea, lakini pale zamani nilikuwa sifiki paka hapa. Nilikuwa siwezi kucheza boli, naona wenzangu anacheza, mimi nakasirika. Lakini sai, niko na wenzangu anacheza na ingia tayari.
This is a ball for you, my sister.
Become the best superstar, sawa.
With Bimbin Africa, there is hope. There is a future for the young Jumbo and many others in Africa. Bimbin Africa, restoring hope. Thank you.